In this video, I'm going to share with you some of my biggest social media do's and don'ts for realtors in 2021. Hey everybody, Katie Lance here, founder and CEO of Katie Lance Consulting, the Get Social Smart Academy, and author of the book, Get Social Smart. And I am so excited because in this episode, I'm going to share with you some of my biggest do's and don'ts. And if you're in real estate, you're going to want to pay attention. By the way, if you're watching this over on YouTube, make sure you hit the subscribe button and the bell button as we have new videos that come out each and every week, and you're not going to want to miss a moment. All right, let's get into some of the do's. When it comes to social media, one of the biggest things that you want to do with social media is you got to show up. So if you've heard me say this before, but you gotta show up. It's so tempting to hand off your social media to somebody else, right? To automate it, to have someone else do it for you. But I can tell you from experience that the agents and brokers that we work with that show up, that are intentional, that connect with people, that don't just talk all about business, but connect on a personal level, get a huge amount of business from social media. So the first do is you gotta show up. The next thing is you gotta be consistent, right? You can't just hop on social media right when you have a new listing. You can't just hop on every now and then. And I have to say, a lot of times I'll go on an agent or broker's Facebook business page, and it doesn't matter if they're in California or Hawaii or New York or wherever they're from. A lot of times I see the same things. I see a listing, I see an article that you might have shared, I see an open house, I see one post on Monday, two on Thursday, nothing for 2 weeks, another one on Sunday, and that consistency makes a big difference. Remember, social media, every platform has an algorithm, and so the way that we can get our content seen by more and more people is consistency. Consistency builds trust. So pick a day, a couple days a week, maybe it's Monday, Wednesday, Friday, Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday, pick a few days where you're going to be consistent with your social media. Put it on your calendar if you need to until it becomes a habit. The other big do is create original content. You've also heard me talk about this as well if you're watching our videos over on YouTube. We talk a lot about original content because as much as I love social media is rented ground. We don't own it. So not only do you need to show up and be consistent, you have to put out some original content. Content like this, whether it's video content, Facebook Live content, it could be podcast content, it could be blog content, but by building up your content library, now you are really building up a great library that goes with you wherever you go, and you're not dependent on any social media platform. Also, original content is informative, but it also gives people a taste, a flavor of who you are and what you're all about, right? And that's one of the best ways to attract business versus chasing leads. So those are the do's. Let's get into the don'ts. Ready? The don'ts. Don't outsource, right? Don't pass your social media off to someone else. Now, that doesn't mean from time to time you might have an assistant who helps you schedule a few posts. You might at some point bring on maybe a video editor to help you edit some of your video content, or maybe a copywriter to help you write a little bit of content better. There's nothing wrong with that. But as I said earlier, we don't want to hand it off to someone else. I often think of social media as like the ultimate dinner party. Imagine having a dinner party with your most important clients, and instead of you being there, you have your assistant there running the whole thing. We would never do that, but that's what happens when we hand it off completely to someone else. So don't outsource, that's a big don't. The other two don'ts that I wanna mention here are don't spam. We don't wanna spam people, right? Nobody likes to be spammed, nobody likes to be sold, which leads to my next don't, which is don't sell, sell, sell. So we don't wanna spam and we don't wanna sell. So there's a percentage of what you wanna talk about when it comes to business, right, versus personal. So I really believe like in the 80-20 rule, where 80% of what we talk about is personal and the other 20% is business. And by the way, when we're talking about business, it doesn't have to be super salesy. It can be educational, it can be informative. So you might start to put out some great content around what it feels like to buy or sell real estate in your local community. If someone's moving to the area, what are some things that they need to know? What are some of the biggest myths for people moving into your area? What are the biggest mistakes movers make when you're moving to a new location? These types of things are really relevant, and you know, they are kind of selling who you are because you're sharing this really valuable information, but you're also doing it from a place of being really helpful. And this is how we become, you know, that helpful person, that go-to person in our local network. So those are a few things we don't want to do. We don't want to outsource. We don't want to spam anybody, right? And also, by the way, when I mean spamming, we don't want to send people a bunch of just random private messages on social media. I see this happen all the time. I see someone, you know, connects with me on LinkedIn, and the next thing they do is they message me and they say, "Hey, Katie, will you follow me over on Facebook?" right? I don't even know them yet. So we want to take the time to build those relationships. We don't want to spam. We don't want to be overly salesy, but we do want to show up. We want to be authentic. We want to have a strategy in place. We want to put out some consistent original content and ultimately get a plan together, because that's what's going to help in the long run. All right. I would love to hear from you. What are your biggest pain points when it comes to social media? Let me know in the comments below. I would love to help you out. And if you are listening to this going, you know, I really need to get started with social media. Maybe you're at the beginning stages of social media, or maybe you need a little bit of a reboot. I would invite you to download our free content grid. Go to katielance.com/content grid, katielance.com/content grid. It's going to ask for your name and email. Put that in and we're going to send you a content grid that's been downloaded by tens of thousands of people over the years. It's chock full of ideas and strategies that are really going to help you take your social media strategy to the next level, especially if you are in real estate. All right, guys, make sure you subscribe to the channel so you don't miss anything, and we'll see you next time. Bye for now.